Can't seem to make them stay.
Sundays with Cawd. I don't know if the chat's working. I didn't even try to fix it, to be honest with you. It's too busy. It's... I broke him still.
Oops.
Oh, well. Fuck it. So tonight we're going to finish the Flash Me call. That's all I got for it right now.
You can make it so much more money.
And then in the pipeline, I'll do that later. But I know the next couple we're gonna do.
What up, Lauren's one night stand?
Good gosh. Alright, let's go.
What?
Why do you keep telling me that you don't know if you're in love with me or not? You know how much fucking bullshit that is? Can you blame me? Really?
Yes.
No, you can't. You're doing everything you can to upset me tonight. You're doing everything you can to upset me tonight.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are. Telling me you don't know that if you're in love with me or not?
You were upset all day for no fucking reason.
For no fucking reason, Christ, you didn't want to listen to me all day. You just bolted off and did whatever before you even thought about it.
Oh, baby boy. Hi, Morn. Yes, exactly. It's just a bunch of, like, blue screens of death sounds and... It also says, you've got mail. It's weird. I have seen the new RSO photo. He looks miserable.
He's trying to make it so you can make more money.
Oh, cool, baby.
But it's all... I'm thinking all about me.
Sulk all day about it.
Well, you viewing a bunch of guys' cocks on cam, that didn't thrill me very much.
It didn't thrill him very much for her.
Very much, which means it kind of
thrilled. Bullshit about the Beanie Babies.
Tiny little bit.
I listened to your idea and you got mad. That's my fault somehow.
Not that you listened to my idea. That's not what made me mad. What started irritating me was that you just went off and started doing it without even thinking about it.
What?
I wanted you to think about it, figure out the best way for you to make most money out of it.
This is so stupid.
It is. What's stupid is you telling me that you don't know if you're in love with me or not.
You are complaining for no reason.
Someone asked what the cuppy name is. It's Cucky, which is short for cuckold, right? And Lauren has no idea what that is, right?
He has no idea.
If he did know, I'd be surprised. He thinks missionary is called regular style. So.
I'm not complaining for no reason. I want you to make money.
Texas Deathmatch was awesome.
That's why I've been trying to think of things so that you can make money. I'm not being selfish. I'm trying to think about you.
You did my idea, but you didn't wait.
The purpose of you waiting is so you can think about...
I heard someone else said that.
The purpose of you waiting was so you can figure out the best way for you to make the most money.
Build a bridge.
See, you just want to start your bullshit
again.
Get
over it.
You just want to start your bullshit all over again. God forbid I try to help so you can make more money.
You just want me to agree with what you say or it's quote bullshit.
No. I just want you to think about it so you can make most money. That's what I wanted.
I did, dummy.
I didn't think you were going to just bolt right off and do it. That's why I was mentioning having Maggie Jo in with you.
Did you listen to what I said at the start of the conversation, or did you forget?
Well, which one was that? I'm thinking about me?
Exactly.
No. You tell me how I'm thinking about me when I'm trying to think of ideas for you to make money.
She can
tell me how I'm thinking about me when I'm trying to think...
To make the most money. His idea was to make t-shirts.
Oh,
she still has
that
option.
Yeah, it's not like because she's flashing people for $666 that, like, she can't make t-shirts.
Right, and remember, at the end of last week, he brought his price down to $15.
They should be $100.
So it's...
$100.
I mean, it's not too much different.
$100 and $15, big difference.
If I were him, I'd be more focused on the part where she said, I don't think I love you anymore. It's like, that's way more of a bigger deal.
Well, here's his thought process. You know, if he helps get her more money, she'll want to be back with him, so that's not a problem anymore. Right?
Yeah.
She'll love him again. He's gonna fix this. We got a couple donations. Jill Pill donated, said, I know you could be making a lot more money than these honeys. You're flourish. Now flash me. You're famous. thanks, Jill Pill. You wanna read that one?
Yeah, Gorilla Face Gwen donated and said, would you and Blue Boy be interested in a residual income with websites 50-50? Love you guys.
I think that's supposed to be a kick.
Okay.
Thank you, Gorilla Face Gwen.
Voice to Voice says, what's a buckshot to a kill shot? What's a Samoan slam to a Sumerian slam? Kick, cigarette emoji.
Thanks, everybody. Voice to Voice, thank you, sir.
See, LL Phil J knows. He likes Baby Boy as much as the Rage. Baby Boy
is one of my favorites.
It gets me going.
It's just because there's a point in Baby Boy where it bleeds into, like, Lauren's crying, where he's just like, I just fucking love you so much. Like,
yeah,
that,
it's so, like, satisfying to hear him
can't get it
make
out.
That sound. We have a pretty good one in the pipeline, right?
Yeah, there's one where he cries. he's crying to the point where he was doing those, like,
we heard one the other day.
Squeaks.
Yesterday, I think. Holy shit. It was perfect.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep them listed out. I want to try and cover things that you guys have heard about, like canon events, if you will. Christmas trees one, because everyone keeps asking about that story. I got a call save called Dick Straightening Pills.
Dick Straightening Pills? I wonder what it's about.
Couldn't possibly be those. business deal I'm trying to find, Braden.
What's that?
Business deal is, it's when, Jamie told Lauren that Rod and Todd wanted to go in on a movie together. And I found a part where they talk about it, sort of, but not the full-on call where she agrees to, I think, just Rod or something, but I'm looking. Panicked Lauren is a good one, too, Jack.
He doesn't come around very often, though.
He's very rare. He's a shiny Pokemon.
Tell me how I'm thinking about me when I'm trying to think of ideas so you can make money.
I don't plan on doing a Thanksgiving stream.
No, you weren't listening. You've made that clear.
I'm not repeating it. You don't listen either.
Thank you, everyone who donated.
Yes, I do, stupid.
There you go.
Just because I don't agree with you doesn't mean I'm not listening.
I didn't say you had to agree with me on things, but you could have at least waited and let us talk about things tonight and discuss different ideas. Jesus Christ, can you not talk when I'm talking so you can actually hear me?
I just wanted you to
wait for tonight so you and I could come up with ideas that would be different ideas.
You've repeated this 59 times.
So that you could figure out the best one.
You've repeated this 59 times.
And 59 times you still didn't listen.
Got her. I'm gonna make Filthy Bag of Milk a wrestler. You dirty bag of milk.
I heard it the first time, stupid.
Yeah, sure you did.
Bunch of silence.
Hey, Lorne, go figure. I made more money when I did it than using your ideas.
It's true.
Then do it your way.
She was.
I did.
All I care about, is you making the most money that you can. That's all I cared about, Jamie. It wasn't a matter of if I was right or if I was wrong.
It definitely seemed like it was more about him being right.
It really did. And then he knew he wasn't going to win, and he was just like, I don't care, do whatever you want. I never cared.
But if we would have waited and talked about it tonight, we could have figured it out.
Figured what out?
Anything so that you can make most money. That's all I cared
about. I don't
know
how Jamie figured it out, but she's had people coming in paying to get flashed.
Yeah.
All you've done is complain that I did it my way. Are you kidding right now? Is this a practical joke?
I didn't like it because you're worth more than that.
Cornball.
But you just said you didn't care.
All I care about is you making the most money that you can. How can you take it as an insult when I tell you that I think you're worth more than that?
You can't even keep it straight. This is hilarious.
How can you take it as an insult when I tell you that you're worth more than that? How is that even possible?
Possible. Little Daffy Duck coming out.
When did I say it was an insult?
Well, you sure the hell act like it is.
When did I say it was an insult?
You didn't have to say any words, Junior. Your actions did all the talking.
What actions?
The way you act.
What actions?
I tell you, you're worth more than that, and you act like you...
And the actions?
Like I said something something wrong.
Name the actions.
You tell me to fuck off, and all that bullshit.
Name the actions.
Your words were the actions. I tried to give you the idea of making t-shirts and hats and
fucking
cups
hell.
And shit
How
like
do we
that.
Get past this argument?
Never even paid any attention to that.
Nobody paid attention to the hats and shirts idea.
I mean, I cannot believe this goes on for another hour.
Oh, it goes on for another hour for sure. I love Donnie and said, can't breathe out, you big guys.
Can everyone hear us okay?
Oh, no. Thank you, love. You want to read this one?
Sure. Danforth Anchors says, Lauren thinks if she makes cash, it will rub off on him.
I believe that.
Yeah.
He's expecting to get rich off this porn star so he doesn't have to drive track again. Here we go.
Tyrone Jackson says, I want a Jamie Amy Boutte hat. You just want it to say Jamie Amy Boutte on it, or you want a picture of her?
Does the hat her butt for Boutte? I don't know, yeah. What do you do? Do you put the robot, or do you want, like, the woman?
Oh, I don't know.
Anything would work. Oh, okay. Stevie says they can't hear Hannah. She's not in our home right now. I'm sorry. She is new here still. One minute man historical society donated and said, stop accepting these $10 tips. You're worth more than they had. Hey, thank you.
What about $15?
Listen, you're worth more than that. You need $100 tips. How about $15? Can we do that? Alright.
So me saying your idea didn't work is me insulting you saying I'm worth more. Are you serious?
You acted like you were insulted when I...
Oh, what's the idea?
Her butthole could be the button on top of the hat.
Now, this is a good business idea. We need to get this going right away.
You acted like you were insulted when I said that you were worth more.
When?
Wait, the original, like, her saying I want three floors hasn't come out? I'll look for it, Jack.
When I told you you were worth more than that.
What did I say?
You told me to fuck off. You told me to fuck off.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, you did. You said, fuck you, prick.
No, I didn't.
You did.
I said that to something moron. I said that to something else moron.
Whatever.
Can I get a Wildo shirt?
I don't wonder if they'll let us print those.
Are you in love with me or not, Jamie?
That was answered.
He said, "Do you love me, Jamie?" And there's like 20 seconds like a lot of silence.
Do you think her answer changed from 10 minutes ago?
No, but I really hope that when she says no to this question, he follows up with, "Will you marry me?"
Oh, that'd be great.
You kept telling me to raise the price after I explained it didn't work. You kept telling me my idea was wrong, so I told you to fuck off. But Lawn warps it to I said that when you said I was worth more. Nice try.
Whatever. Doesn't matter. Anything I do, I'm always wrong anyway.
Sure are.
Maggie Jo says that it's right. I say it's wrong.
Oh, bringing MJ into it again.
Just telling you the way you act.
You are a child.
Goddamn God.
Telling you the way you act.
Grow up.
That's right, grow up.
Grow up.
Grow up, Jamie.
At your age, Lawn.
At your age, Jamie.
At your age, Lawn.
Smart ass.
I do. I don't have mommy and auntie bailing me out.
Oh no.
Don't give me any bullshit.
Don't give me any bullshit.
You're the one not acting their age.
Lauren, doesn't say anything for 30 seconds. There's just 30.
Really?
32, look at.
Oh my god, 32 seconds.
32 seconds of dead air after that comment.
Then a cough.
Clear throat.
Oh my god, let me scream over you taking to a friend on the internet for a week. It's fine if he's gay though. Oh, good to know my friends have to meet your criteria.
Whatever.
Prick.
Of course I'm a prick. Oh, let me go to this football game and...
The constant accusations of me cheating on you is why I don't think I love you. It's your doing, no one else.
Oh, let me go to this football game flashing 25,000 people. Then get on...
Right, ignore it.
Carter's... Then get on Carter's shoulders when I'm wearing no panties on with a short skirt. Yeah, I wonder why I should be pissed.
Did we fuck?
I mean, he probably could be mad at that one.
Doesn't fucking matter,
Jamie.
I'm gonna
say that one's fair.
You didn't have any fucking panties on. What the fuck were you doing on another guy's shoulders?
I probably would have just left and not brought it up.
I mean, yeah, I don't know if I would have dated her after
then
that.
Fucking
but...
leave
fucking kidding
not.
Me? Are you fucking kidding me?
I feel like if you continue dating her after that, then it becomes your fault.
Yeah, you set the standard. Yeah, that'd be rough. You know what makes her not do it, though? Is if you just grill her about it 15 times a day.
Right. I don't know what that's gonna do.
The constant accusations of me cheating on you is why I don't think I love you. It's your doing, no one else.
It's my doing. Jamie, you sat on another guy's goddamn shoulders, no fucking panties on, and a short skirt.
To this.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Why is he being brought up again?
Okay, Lawn, explain, James.
It's the only thing he's got.
I'm not gonna explain, James. So I was
exactly
wrong about
you
James.
Can't.
At least I admit when I was fucking wrong. I was wrong about James. So fucking sorry. Said that already.
Well, at least he said sorry, I guess.
You don't hear that though.
If Jamie had said sorry, would that have been the end of it? I fucking doubt
no.
it.
Then it'd be like grilling about every detail of every second they've had together. The person she did it with, you know. How long did you talk? I need to see your
no,
phone.
No, of course not.
I need to see a picture that you deleted. His number.
Try to say this name real quick.
I'm alright.
You have to do it. She asked nicely.
No, I'm good.
Lady Sardonicus. That's how Blue
Sardoni.
Boy would
say. Sardoni.
That was way no, different that's... than what I thought it was pronounced.
No. You got a question here?
Oh, sure. Can I ask when Blue Boy became a part of the behind the scenes of the calls?
I don't know any of that information. That's Wolf
was
stuff.
He there the entire time? I was not there the entire time. I made a Photoshop for one of the catfishing things. And then it, after that... I think once it was learned I could be trusted to not tell everyone, like, you know, Rotus Chutootsie did, that that I was cool enough to be all behind right. the scenes.
Let's, thank you for your question. Let's get back to the call.
Right, so that takes the whole week of abuse away.
Abram.
Are you really that dense?
Explain the fucking thought process of sitting on
right,
Tyler's
so
shoulders
that takes
and no
the whole
fucking
week of abuse away. Are you really that dense?
Explain the thought process of sitting on
right,
Kyler's
so
shoulders with no fucking panties on.
Away. Are you really that dense?
Lauren said, tell me the thought process on sitting on Carter's shoulders with no panties
well,
on.
Well, she couldn't see over the people, even though she's like 6 foot three.
She's a 6 foot woman and she needed to be on Carter's shoulders at the football game.
Yeah. Man, imagine sitting behind them.
You're not gonna see
yes.
shit. Carter's neck looked cold. Oh my god.
Explain the thought process
right,
sitting
so that
on Kyler's shoulder.
Week of abuse
well, fuck
away.
You.
Are you really that
fuck
dense?
You. You just want to fucking interrupt me and not answer any questions I have.
Fuck you.
You're famous for that.
Because you want to deflect constantly.
No, well... You don't see me sitting on some girl's shoulders or
right,
fucking
so that
sticking
takes
my cock
out.
I would love to see
her
sitting on
are
some
you really
girl's
that
shoulders. Why didn't he say you didn't see a girl sitting on my neck? Why would he be the one to sit on her shoulder?
Yeah, why? What about? Did he give an equivalent of the no panties on? Did he say jock strap again? Because he thinks.
Oh, did he? I don't know.
No, I'm asking.
I was talking over it. So I might want to go back.
But no, that's a great question. Why did he say
he put himself in the woman's role?
He's naked on a woman. He's naked from the pants.
His little
down
Lauren
on a
can't
shoulders.
See over people, so he has to be on top.
My pecker was on her neck. Are you jealous? No. Bullshit.
You don't see me sitting on some girl's shoulders or
right,
fucking
so
sticking my
cock.
So that
takes the whole week of abuse away. Are you really that
you
dense?
Don't, you don't see me sticking right. my cock on some girl's shoulders.
So that takes the whole week of abuse away. Are you really that dense?
Whatever, Jamie.
I'm putting my dick on a woman's shoulders.
You know what, Lauren, when you put it like that, you know what, you're right, and I'm sorry.
You know what? I apologize.
I did not think of it from your perspective.
When you put it that way, Lauren, you're right.
Whatever, Lauren.
Fucking bullshit.
You are bullshit.
No, of course I am. Because I don't like my fiance
How's
sitting on some guy's
man?
Shoulders with no goddamn penny or panties on.
Fiance, even though she just said I don't love you anymore.
I don't love you. Okay, well, we are still engaged. So...
Matilda's doing the moonwalk right now.
Oh, fuck. I just hit the wrong button. I know she's broken right now. I gotta go back and find where we were.
Wait, are you kidding right now? Is this a practical joke?
And hats and cups and shit like that. Never even paid any attention to that.
I don't think I hear this part. Sorry, guys.
And how can you take it as an insult when I tell you that I think you're worth more
My
than
God,
that?
You can't even keep it straight. Telling me to raise the price after I explained it didn't work.
Okay, sorry, guys.
I'm not gonna explain, James, so I was
exactly
wrong about James.
Can't.
Okay, we're close.
He's taking my cock on some girl's shoulder.
So that
Got
takes
it.
The whole week of abuse away. Are you really that dense?
Whatever, Jamie.
Whatever, Lorne.
Fucking bullshit.
You are bullshit.
No, well, of course I am.
Sure, count of three, everybody OD says. Lawrence Pekka wouldn't reach their neck.
Oh, no. What would you say to it? Ramona's Diaper also done and said, I think you boys are worth $100. Wait, $20. Okay, $15. But are you in love with me or not? Now, see, if you would have asked me to marry you there, you may have gotten a yes, because that would be the appropriate time. Thank you, Ramona's Diaper. Thank you. Bathing in the tub? Which ones?
I thought you put that up.
When he had all the bubbles on his head, like hair?
No, the one where his... I think you cropped out his little pecker poking out of the water, but I thought you put it on the screen.
Oh, man. I hope just for your guys' sake I didn't.
I'm pretty sure you did.
In yellow water? Oh, God, yeah. With nicotine.
It was a murky brown.
A murky brown?
It was like the same color as his weak coffee.
Oh, God. I can drink it all day long. It doesn't get me out.
I don't like my fiance sitting on some guy's shoulders with no goddamn panty or panties on.
Talk about the panties again.
I'm bullshit because I don't like my fiance sitting on some guy's panties. Sitting on some guy's shoulders with no fucking panties on. Yeah, what?
Did he just say sitting on some guy's panties?
I don't even know.
I'm bullshit because I don't like my fiance sitting on some guy's panties.
Sitting on some guy's panties.
Sitting on some guy's panties.
A dummy. Sitting on some guy's shoulders with no fucking panties on. Yeah, whatever.
There we go. At least he got to correct himself.
How's dump truck man?
Whatever.
I would like to talk about dump truck man and Christmas tree if I can real quick. Now, Jamie does get repetitive. I understand that. And I know that Jamie brings up dump truck man and the Christmas tree as much as she possibly can. She'll probably drop it, but they're two of the dumbest lies you could ever come up with. I feel like you have to be reminded of it almost daily at that point. Just like, why lie about a 4-foot Christmas tree?
Do you have that call lined up soon?
Yeah, it's gonna be next.
Okay, yeah. That's a good one.
Yeah, he gets... he gets, caught real red-handed. The Go Fish sexual game, I haven't heard it since it... Will showed it to me. he's asking, they have a conversation about how they played games in the hot tub and he wants to know what it is. And she doesn't answer for a while and then says something about go fish and then being naked. I don't know when it happened though. It's going to take some work to find that one.
It's like Little Miss Namecaller points out, it's the fact that he said there was the guy had both of his dump trucks there.
Two drunk dump trucks at one location. And it wasn't his business. He ran into him in Skowhegan or whatever the hell.
I mean, you gotta be better at lying than that if you're gonna lie this consistently.
I noticed he had two dump trucks, one was empty, and I said, can I draw a debt? And he said no. That was me applying for a job. Hey, you guys looking for people? No. I'll applaud myself today.
Got your insurance yet?
Doesn't matter.
You are bullshit.
I am bullshit, of course.
Oh, God.
Can't answer that whole week of abuse doesn't go away saying sorry, huh?
Whatever. All you want to do is fight anyway.
That may be true.
You started this, moron.
I started. I came up with a fucking idea that obviously I never should have came up with.
You do this
fight throughout the whole fucking day.
You do this all the time. You start it and then you try to act like it's me.
Yep. I'm not trying to act like it's you.
You just did.
We're not going to agree on everything, and I accept that.
You just did.
But I'm not going to like it when you tell me that you don't know if you love me or not. That's fucking horseshit.
But all you want to do is fight.
Well, you do. You find fucking things to try to pick at me about. You try to find things constantly to pick at me about. You never used to do that until you get down in Tennessee.
Pay your traffic ticket.
Until she got down in Tennessee. She's been there for like two years at this point.
When?
Fuck, I paid that a month ago.
Okay.
Why, was you going to try to get on me about that?
I mean, as someone pointed out in the chat, it's like, just leave. Just, why do this day in and day out?
I don't know.
Just leave.
Sorry I ruined your fun on that one.
Your fun on that one.
What the fuck, Lorne? You've never not told me things before. What the fuck is going on?
I think I did tell you. More than likely, I did tell you.
You've never not told me things before. What is going on?
I haven't stopped either, have I?
You've never not told me things before. What is going on?
Not a damn thing's going on. I still tell you things.
You didn't tell me about it. Something clearly is going on.
Oh, I think I did tell you about it.
You didn't tell me about it. Something clearly is going on.
I think I did tell you about it.
You didn't.
I think I did.
You didn't.
You can probably look back in the text and you'll probably find it. I probably did.
I'm telling you that you didn't.
Do you look back in your text? I probably did.
Lorne is a robot.
Probably did. When I'm saying you didn't, he.
Oh, man.
If I didn't say it to you in text, then I told you over the phone.
You didn't.
I didn't tell you the last time I took a shit, either.
You didn't tell me about it. Something clearly is going on.
Jamie's just trying to make Lorne understand how Lorne is, and it's not working, unfortunately.
I know what you're doing, Jamie.
You've never not told me.
Yeah.
It's annoying, isn't it, Lorne?
Yeah, is this annoying or what, man?
Sure. DSP Historical Society says, Blue Boy voice reveal when? Or will he always use the changer? I'm going to keep using this Kermit the Frog voice changer. Forever. And I hope you're behaving yourself.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Where did you get this voice changer I need?
I got the voice changer from Amazon.com. That's www.
Ella Fool, Joseph Dancer.
Thank you for donating, though.
Thank you. How much technical preparation went into the more involved calls? Like, did Lauren have to test the distance at which the sound worked for a third-party shit-talk call? Thank you, Ella Fool, J. Not much.
I think I've said it before. We always had, like, a plan in place.
Sort of, yeah.
And then it never went that way. There's no plan.
Basically, if I had a way to explain it to everyone, you'd say he, and Lorne would say ha. Definitely check. Does not like being treated like he treats people. He thinks it's unfair and cries and yada yada. Thank you guys for donating.
What about that job today?
What about it? They haven't called me. What about it? I stopped in there to make sure I gave them the right number. Because where I kept giving the wrong number out, my phone number before. So they said they were in there going through the applications. And I was like, well, actually, that was right after I talked to you.
Thought they were. You said it would be next day.
That's what they told me, but obviously it wasn't. So they were in there going through applications. That was around 2 o'clock.
Guess you didn't get it.
Don't know yet. They were going through applications. They did that the whole day. The same thing the whole day. They had a thing where you drive up and fill out an application. They take you in,
tell
you about the whole thing, and they do that same thing with everyone.
This sounds like Dump Truck Man all over again.
Oh, good fucking God.
Jeffrey does have a scar on his side. I don't know why.
I don't care if you believe me or not, Jamie. You just accused me of lying anyway.
You said you had an interview and a job offer today.
Yeah, well, that's what they told me. They told me they'd call me today for an interview and an offer.
What's the name of the offer? Doesn't one come before the other usually?
Yeah. For a man who interviews for a lot of jobs, I don't think he seems to understand what some things are, but...
I think he gets told, like, you know, like, yeah, we're hiring, and he's just like, I'm in.
Yeah, like, they explain to him, you know, what a normal person interviewer would do. Explain the job, the role, how much you're getting paid, what it could look like, benefits, and he's like, I got the job.
Yeah. And then he never gets the job.
No.
I don't think I've ever... Now that I think about it, do you recall any times he actually had an interview?
No.
I don't either. I can't think of a single time he like was like, all right, baby, going somewhere for an interview.
He would go, and then I actually was listening to something earlier. He goes places, and then when he gets there and talks to someone, and they give him this basic information, he thinks that's a first interview. He's like, they said they might call me for a second interview. And they're like, no, you weren't interviewed. You were told about the job. What the fuck are you? I don't know. He's very out of touch.
No, I kind of says if they give you a hat, you're. I mean.
Well, yeah.
They give you a gift bag on the way out.
Oh yeah, at a job fair. They're not handing out that to everyone.
Shift.
Mark is in the ring right now. He's Jamie's nurse at one point.
Shift what?
I don't know. That's the bigger company that owns them.
Spell it.
Shift.
Wait, what? Can we rewind that one time?
Christ, why?
What part of this part?
Yeah.
Shift what?
No, a little bit further. I think she asked him what the company's name. He gives her, like, the parent company for some reason.
You just accused me of lying anyway.
You said you had an interview and a job offer today.
Yeah, well, that's what they told me. They told me they'd call me today for an interview and an offer.
What's the name of the business?
Shift.
Is this like a Jeff Chef moment or?
Shift what?
I don't know. That's the bigger company that owns them.
See, why would you say that? That's like me saying like I'm. I don't know, whoever owns fucking the UFC. Or, you know what I mean? Like, why would you give the parent company's name? I don't know why I went to UFC. I don't know why that came to my head first.
A TKO. He's just lying. He's either lying or he just has no grasp on what an actual interview is. But, like, I don't know. This is just stupidity.
Joy Orbison says, are all interviews about DriveTrock?
Almost all of them.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. Is there any that weren't truck driving? I know that probation...
They offered him that janitorial or maintenance.
It was a gas station clerk, right?
Something like that.
Or like a gas station machine repairman?
Yeah, it wasn't a cash register. It was like...
He was, like, doing maintenance on equipment for a gas station.
Yeah.
To me, that means he's fixing the fountain drinks.
Too many kids at a gas station. He turned it down.
He said, turned it down because he said there were too many kids at a gas station.
He said that, but he also said that the amount... After he realized he said something stupid like that, he corrected himself and said he was making not enough money to even drive there to the job.
Is there any other ones that you can think of?
He always said he would work at Burger King if he had to, but he never applied to any fast food joints. I think...
Well, because he didn't have to. He had the unemployment.
Well, yeah, he wrote that. He did that carpentry work for that one woman. But outside of that, I don't think... The only other person that was applying for him was his aunt for most of it. He rarely did it himself because he's a lazy piece of shit and has his elderly relatives help him apply for jobs because he can't get on internet. as he would say.
Internet.
So, like, Jamie would tell him, well, go to these businesses and fucking ask, dude. Like, it's not hard. You're doing nothing all day. Oh, I gotta do class from 1 to 2.
Oh, an auto parts store.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, maybe. I mean, I think with his charge, he is pretty limited.
Yeah,
but
he's limited on... Also, his skill set. He hasn't really done anything much more outside of trucking for his entire life.
Yeah.
So, unfortunately, I think this is kind of what he has to do. That and pallet salesman.
He called Arsene Moore a few times. From when he got out of prison, immediately he was trying to get that job back because he thought they were going to hold it for him while he was incarcerated for 6 months.
Mm-hmm. I mean, his resume, guys, is pretty fucking hysterical.
I think it's bare bones. I hope that on his resume he does, like, his classwork where it's just like, when I was 9, I was cutting wood in the forest. What did he say? I can't remember the line anymore. Something about cutting wood. Cutting logs, cutting wood. He was like 7 or 9 or some shit.
When you see his resume, I feel like it's like a 15-year-old applying for his first job type of thing. You know, he has like one sentence on it.
There's a lot of blank space on that resume. Yeah, it's got to be rough. Why not? I've been driving for Clark's milk. Oh, yeah, yeah. One of his jobs on his application is playing meat man with his friends. Lauren was on a basketball team and made the whole school turn on him when he stopped playing. That's how good he was or something.
Spell it.
Yeah.
James,
oh, fuck. Christ, why?
He can't spell.
What's the matter? Do you think I'm lying to you? You want to check up on me?
Probably. Interesting.
SHYFT. Shift group.
Checking up.
Alright, everyone Google shift group. Let's figure out what this is.
You need to stop thinking that I'm telling you things that are full of shit.
This dude lies compulsively. Why would
you insist that you weren't lying about dump truck man, so why wouldn't I think you were making this up?
How long ago was that?
What does that matter?
How long ago was it, Danny?
Shin says he thinks that shift is a temporary job agency.
No, it's a... It's a,
NASDAQ.
A automotive manufacturer behind respected brands like... Royal Truck Body, Strobes R Us, Spartan RV, and Biltmore Contract Manufacturing. So...
Well, there you go. And...
I don't know what Lauren could have done for them.
The joke's on all of us because Lauren works there, so. Oh, wait.
You lied
aren't
to
you
me.
Constantly telling, aren't you constantly
does
telling
that
me. To, aren't you constantly telling me to let go of the past?
You brought up the past tonight, dummy.
The fuck was the name of that bitch?
You brought up the past tonight, dummy.
You did too. I'm trying to look for the actual name of this company.
The point is you made that up and you were pissed off I was asking about him.
Okay. DSP Historical Society says you have the Jordan Peterson voice changer. Sweet. I don't know what that means. Can't.
Good gravy, DSP.
Good gravy. Platy says, first of all, I want you. Has Lauren ever finished a song without coughing through it?
There's a few, but it's like he throws in the nim nim nims.
And then we have Jason X. Give Lauren a break. He has class for an hour on Thursday. Friday it's supposed to rain, then yeah. It's the weekend. He'll look for a job next week if he has time. That is how he thinks.
Yeah, that's his. It's definitely his thought process. Ridiculous. Well, I got a doctor's appointment at 8 in the morning. It should be about an hour. My day's booked.
What job was it? Was it the one where he's putting the... He worked at that wood place. What was it?
When was this?
Remember he had to put those, like, stickers between the lumber?
I don't...
You don't remember that?
No, I don't remember that.
He worked there for, like, 2 months. And he got fired because he kept calling in because of the snow, but everyone else was going into work?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because it wasn't the last day he got fired was when he had to take his mom to the airport.
He had to take his mom to the airport, and that was the last straw. Because they were like, what time did you go to take your mom to the airport? And it was like 6:30 in the morning. And they're like, you don't start till 9.
Yeah, right.
Like, why do you have, to call it the whole day?
I'm going to have to call it the day. I got to drive my mother to the airport.
So he called in and they fired him. But prior to that, it said in a call. I don't know if it's a throuple call or if it was a Jamie thing. It wasn't when it was just Casey.
It might have been just Jamie right before or something. Because
I lost my train of thought.
Sorry. He was doing the lumber thing.
Oh, yeah. He just kept calling in on when it was snowing outside.
Yeah, not calling in. He didn't want to drive that wood on the slick roads.
He didn't have to drive the wood. Remember? He worked in the factory. He had to put, like... He called them stickers. I don't know what it is, but it was, like, something to divide the lumber?
Separate them.
Like, separate them so they were easier to pick up or something like that? I don't know.
Real painstaking shit right there.
Yeah.
Oh, well. And then Joy Orbison is asking if we can get a Mama Gwen impression.
When something Mama Gwen says, I can give him one.
I mean transmission.
All right, well, there it is.
Well, that was me, though.
Oh, I mean transmission.
That's pretty good.
What?
You do a what squawk? An old bird?
I don't know if I can.
What? 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 I'm making a fool of you. That's not what they think.
Thank you, everybody. Appreciate it.
Well, I made a mistake. All
right? Just like right
now. I shouldn't have lied to you before, all right? So I made a fucking mistake. You can stop holding it against me now.
I would like to point out that I can top the getting fired for not going in for the snow and then mom.
Mm-hmm.
When Lauren called out for his first day at work for crying.
Yeah, that was the most pathetic.
He was kind of about something Jamie did. She's like meeting a guy to have sex or going to do porn for the first time in a while, and he cried all night and called out at work and said something came up.
No, didn't he? I thought he told them it was for crying.
I was crying all night to him.
I could be wrong. You're probably right. That'd be embarrassing.
Okay, I just can't make it.
Fucking bitch, though. I mean.
I can't believe.
That was the morning he went and bought himself the chocolates, was it not?
Oh, was it?
Was that a different time?
I think it was a different time. No. I don't know, there's things that happen like multiple times and it's hard to figure out which one it was.
Okay, love.
Whatever.
He also called it a work because Roscoe got hit by a skunk.
Sprayed by a skunk.
No, that's what I mean.
Not hit by a skunk.
Well,
a skunk wasn't driving a car and hit Roscoe.
The skunk aimed and shot.
There you
got
go.
It. So,
whatever.
I'm looking for the actual name of this business. I saw it on here before.
How do you not know the company you applied for?
Right there.
Yeah, I can't wait for the company I applied to call back and give me a job.
Lots of papers for just filling out an application.
Yeah, well, I'll take a picture of the fucking plastic bag of stuff that they gave me. And I didn't even know if I was hired.
It's a job fair, you fuck.
Why the fuck would they give me all this if I'm not even fucking hired?
And you're thinking, like, you
they
want to
hire people. They're hiring a lot of people. Duramag.
Oh, that was one of them.
Duramag.
Not on the list.
Like, the bag of stuff. He's got a bag. This is how he knows he's going to get there. So you'd think it'd be, what, clothing, tools?
Yeah, they gave him a pen.
A pen.
and
with their name on it.
Yeah, fucking, like a keychain.
They want me to work there. They gave me a keychain.
Yes, buddy. He thinks this is a job offer.
I guess we have some dumb. Roofface Gwen donated and said, "Want to have some respect on my name? Taking the piss." Thank you.
And Ruthie R says, "Will we get to hear the church songs that Lorne wrote/sang?" Yes, he does sing them at some point.
Yeah, he's like, "People go to church on a Sunday."
It's fucking terrible.
It's something like that. It's fucking, it's just trash. Thank you, everybody.
But yes,
you
are. Dura Mag.
Let's hear all the swag.
That's the name of the business.
See if this company's giving out the goods.
Dura Mag.
Yes. Shift Group are the ones that bought them out. They used to, when it was just Duramag, they employed like 200 people. Shift Group bought them out. D-U-R-A-M-A-G. Two separate words. Shift Group bought them out, and now it's like a company of like 3,000.
Whoa. Yeah, I'll play Jamie's song. Give me a minute.
Like they gave me a plastic bag with a big old notebook on it that says Shift Group on it, and a cup holder that said, says Duramag, a mask, some fucking thing to hold a card, a key card.
Give me a laser pointer, a lanyard, you fuck.
This is absolute swag.
Thing to hold a key card.
And hold a...
and a pen.
Ooh, a pen!
They did give him a pen. So that's just job fair swag.
You know why they gave him the pen? To sign that deal.
Oh, boom. Yeah. And the lanyard.
My God, he's so stupid. That was a job offer.
So when they said you would have an interview today, did wink at you or something? Or did you assume you'd get one?
I assumed that the interview would be today. That's what she told me, that they called me today with an interview and an offer. But they had a lot of applications to go over too. So, you know, they'll call me when they call me. They don't, I have another application in at...
Wait a minute.
Alcon.
So Duramag's a firearm company?
Wait, why does Lauren think they're not going to call him? They gave him a bag with a pen in it. He's got the job.
Yeah, man, you're basically in.
You're in, bro. All right, for the person that wanted Jamie's song, here it is. Whenever it loads. Right. Maybe right now. Read now. Please.
I know we may not get along all the time.
Real quick, I'll start it over, because that line is very telling. Shins, he did not get the job. Surprise, surprise. It wasn't an interview.
What?
It was just swag. No, this is for Jamie.
I know we may not get along all the time.
Probably has the same lyrics, honestly.
We both can be stubborn if we're right or wrong. The feelings we share make it change. And part of me is missing when you're gone.
Phone is cutting out.
I may not always be that easy to talk to.
You never are.
I may not always say the words that are right.
You never do.
I may not always see the times when you're sad and hurting.
Hurting.
Yeah, I want to be there by your side.
Yee!
I want to love you for life.
I want to love you for life.
I know my memory's not the greatest in the world. I might forget things more often.
Even his phone's tapping out. Fuck this.
I'd hold you in
he wrote this,
forever
yes.
If I could.
Probably took him all day.
May not always be that easy to talk to. I may not always say the words that I write.
I used to sing
I may not always see the times when you're sad and when you're hurting.
When you're sad and when you're hurting.
But Jimmy, I wanna be there.
That's what the song is. Hurting to stop.
I wanna love you for life.
For life.
But Jimmy, I wanna be there by your side.
That was personal.
So please, can I take you as my wife?
Oh, the proposal at the end.
Love you.
Love you.
My
wife. I love you.
I mean, there's always a marriage proposal around the corner.
Yeah.
Do you guys want to hear another Jamie song? There's one I really want to hear. It starts like this. I already forgot how it went now. But it's good. It song of proposal.
You want to know which artist? It's your leaper. I love you, honey. Will you marry me?
So, how'd you guys get engaged? Well, he sang on my answer machine and proposed.
Well, he left me a
voicemail. I just couldn't shake it off.
This is another Jamie song.
And it's held me back for so long. What other road could I take? How could I be so wrong?
This is it. Sorry, that one sucks. Look, this one's got an upbeat tempo.
Without you, I've learned a lesson that I don't mind talking about. And right now I count my blessings that I've had this time to figure it out. As we've gone through all our changes, the ups and downs, the ins and outs, there is one thing I know for certain.
It's trash.
I don't ever want to live.
You want to put this on? You're about to make love to a woman. Light a few candles.
Let me set the mood.
Set
babe.
The mood.
Let me
dim the lights. And blast this.
Without you. All
right, that's enough of Jamie's songs. They'll get music videos at some point.
Yeah, this is a song Will Ripper posters down to, was it? Is he singing real?
It might have been, I don't know.
Take oh, you're right, Brayden.
All right, let's get back to this call where they're arguing about the same thing.
You can tell me, you can stop telling me that I'm full of shit because I don't lie to you anymore.
Oh.
I lied to you that one time and that was it.
Is 4 Foot Christmas Tree after this call?
Honey, come on.
We're playing it next, yeah.
No, I mean timeline-wise.
No, this was on...
Because that was in February?
No, he says he had it in February.
Oh.
This is October 30th, 2020. Christmas Tree took place on November 9th, 2020.
Look at Noel's bitch ass.
So like
here.
A week later, a little over a week later. Who's wrestling? Please, can I take you?
That's John Dupay. John Duppy.
Hey, baby. And Gigi. Talk my angel like that, dog.
Come on.
The ultimate battle.
Don't be like that.
Sure, you did laugh.
Don't be like that.
I can't even trust you.
Oh, guys. Don't even start giving me a bunch of goddamn bullshit.
I need to think.
Oh, well, go fucking think then.
And it's over, guys.
And that's it. There's no way this continues.
Hello?
Hey, Lauren. Oh. It's Will.
Hey, Will.
Now things are going to get
crazy. How you doing? Will was on this call.
I'm good. What the heck is going on?
I don't know.
She's really upset right now.
All we've been doing tonight is upsetting each other.
Yeah, I said, how's Lauren? She said, fuck that.
Yeah.
What's that all about?
Well, we've just been upsetting each other all night tonight.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm just fucking tired of some of the bullshit.
Oh, like what?
So, you know, just things between me and her that we disagree on some stuff.
You don't say.
Disagree.
We disagree on some sudden just normal couple bullshit.
Oh,
I don't
okay.
think this is normal couple
bullshit. Well,
that's
no reason to fight, though.
No, not at all.
Well, we argue, though.
Yeah.
We argue and we get over it. But
you're not mad about the Halloween party, are you?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, I mean, I just want her to be safe.
Well, she's always safe. I mean,
it's just as, well, the football game weren't very safe.
Why?
No. I don't know what you're thinking there.
Why is that not safe?
Because she came back, wound up getting sick.
Yeah, but she wore a mask the whole time.
Yeah, but I mean, it sucks because she's having a hard time recovering as it is. But then she goes out to a football game.
And, yeah, but she wanted a day of fun.
It's obvious. I understand that.
Yeah.
I don't have a problem with her having a day of fun at all.
Just like when he's talking to Willow, he like tries to make it sound so like reasonable, and like it was just a normal conversation, you know, where I said I didn't want you going out because we were gonna get sick again. And then on the phone with Jamie, you put your pussy on some guy's neck.
What about Carter's neck when you didn't have any panties on?
You know, we just had a slight little disagreement.
Listen,
you know?
we don't need people meddling in our relationship. We can handle this on ourselves. And then they just repeat each other for an hour. I'm not gonna be married to Will. It's not gonna be me, you, and Will.
Right, but there was social distancing, and she had a mask on.
Yeah, but how can you social distance in an arena full of 25,000 people?
They don't fill it to capacity.
It's quarter of capacity.
That's what Maggie Jo said, was there's 25,000 people there.
Okay.
But Maggie Jo said there was 25,000 people there.
That's probably not capacity then.
Right.
Must be damn big arena.
The stadium can hold like almost 100,000 people. It means it's a quarter, which means it follows the regulation. Like, you know, there's regulations in place, right?
Yeah, I do. I don't know that there's the arena. I've never seen it.
Right, no, but like the country's running, you know, rules about social distancing and like
COVID.
Well,
public,
hey
guys, some of that.
It's really fucked up now. Is it even in Maine? It's fucking today. There's over 100 people that came down with
what?
Positive. Yeah, over 100 people in Maine.
Oh my god.
Today it was a record. Today was it set a new record today. Over 100 people in Maine came down with coronavirus.
So 100 total people there, or 100 today?
Today.
Oh my god.
Just today. And seems... It's been growing every day.
It seems like nowhere is safe, Wayne.
I know.
No.
COVID
can't get you in.
There's one safe haven in the world. The entire world. It's
me. Get back to living.
Right. Well, that's just not in the cards right now, you know? So you got to take your opportunities when you can. Like, I mean, as far as, you know, the foosball goes,
COVID was really a blessing for the catfishing.
Can't do it.
Because you seriously can't.
There's a pandemic going on. People are out here losing their voices and talking like a speaking spell. So. You want me to play it back?
Fucking irritating as hell.
It's
pandemic. Fucking back to living.
Right. Well, that's just not in the cards right now, you know? So you gotta take your opportunities when you can. Like, I mean, as far as, you know, the foosball goes, I mean, I'm not a fan or anything, but that was a pretty big game.
Foosball.
It was important,
foosball.
You know? Like, you can't turn down those tickets. And when they're running the rules so that, you know, there's proper distancing and masks are required and all that, I don't see what the issue would be.
Well, I just think about the 25,000 people being there.
Right, but it's not like all 25 are on top of her, you know?
And she left without getting COVID. So why is this even still being discussed?
Right, yeah, she didn't get COVID. She just had a cold. Major fucking issue. I think that Will... I think there may be some shoosh concerns. Oh wait, Love Donian said, is Blue Boy still doing the YouTube thing? He hasn't asked for likes.
Give me likes. Give
you
me all your
a
likes.
Song about likes, liking, and subscribing and sharing.
Oh, no, we're still doing that. Yeah. We're still on the journey to 100,000.
To 100,000.
We're getting close.
Egberto Stoney said, one of my favorites is when Will did the use to Lauren, and Lauren got really hurt. Can I request Blueborn do the UUU as well? Thank you.
You.
I just like kind of bail on it and then start making another noise because it's more long.
Hey, you start sounding like an orangutan.
You. You're gonna like make your voice crack so you sound as good as Lauren does. But that was a very good job. Round of applause, everyone. Thank you, Egbert, and love.
Octopussy, don't offend the snowflakes, okay?
I just think about her being sick already and having a hard time recovering.
No.
I mean you want to be a shark. You guys went there so that she could get better.
Right, I understand
that. Two times she's fallen backwards.
Yeah, but I mean, that's just life, you know?
Let the girl have some fun, you know?
Maybe it's not even her doing that. So what happens if she was staying at home and she still went backwards? Would you still be yelling?
No, I'm not even yelling at her now.
Oh, come on.
It was something we were both irritating.
I mean, you're laughing. You were yelling at her. Just don't know, man.
I didn't yell.
Okay.
I get tired of yelling.
All right, Lang.
Thanks, Ruthie.
Well, I did.
Okay.
But, well,
I mean,
whatever.
To be fair, like, you were presenting me with stuff saying she was cheating with this guy online, you know, and that wasn't even the case.
I was wrong about that, and I apologize to everybody for my misbehavior there.
Right.
But, you know, I know she's not cheating on me. There's some things she does that I don't like.
Right, but when you're saying things like, you know, she told me you had said something to the effect of, like, you're consistently cheating on me. That's not, like, you know, that really goes against your argument that you don't think she does.
Well, when she tells me things like she sat on Carter's shoulders and weren't wearing any panties.
Well,
wearing a short skirt.
Let me ask you this. Did you say that before after you heard that information?
Did I say what?
That she was constantly cheating on you. Did you say that before or after that happened?
I don't know.
Well, it was during the week with that guy, so I would assume it was before.
During the week of that guy, it was probably... I don't know. I don't even remember. So when she tells me shit like, oh, like she told me that she sat on Carter's shoulders with no panties on and a short skirt.
Well, I mean, she probably didn't do that on purpose, though. Like,
well, no, she got on his shoulders.
Well, I know, but she was probably riding it, but it's like, it doesn't, you know, she probably didn't mean to wear that outfit for the sole purpose of getting on his shoulders.
Well,
she didn't have any clean panties.
Well, that was
the washer broke. That's my fault.
So still, it's...
I put two comforters in there at once and it just broke.
She has a fiance. What's she going to get on another guy's shoulders for when she doesn't have any panties?
She doesn't love
see over the Well, I mean, I don't think she was even thinking about that part. She just wanted to see over the crowd from what I was told.
Well, she's 6 feet tall.
Yeah, I know, but that doesn't mean that you can see, you know, for infinity when...
Still, it's, you know, that's like me saying I'm going to set my car on some girl's shoulders.
Still.
I'm pretty sure that's not how she put it to you.
Did he say why didn't you get on a girl's
shoulders? That's what I thought he said.
Was your girl shoulder?
Still, it's, you know, that's like me saying I'm gonna set my cock on some girl's shoulders.
Oh, put his cock on.
I'm pretty sure that's not how she put it.
And that's entirely different. Are you putting your cock on her shoulders so you can see over the crowd? She's not.
I gotta see over this crowd. Hold on, hold me up by my wiener.
Whip my cock out and put it on your shoulder.
Hold on, let me rest on the hook.
No, but you know, it's same kind of thing.
Right, so when she said, hey, yeah, I got on Carter's shoulders, it was fun, she actually just said to you, hey, I'm going to put my pussy on this guy's shoulders.
Well, she kept telling me how He said his neck was getting warm.
Maybe that's when she realized she wasn't wearing panties.
That's a good point. I never thought of that.
That's just fucking bullshit.
Oh.
How do you know?
That's shit that shouldn't be fucking happening anyway. That's fucking horse shit.
Why?
Why? Because when you have a fiance, you just don't act like that. You don't behave
get
like
on
that.
Someone else's shoulders?
Yeah, with no panties on.
Okay, again, Lauren, you're really focused behaving on that one thing. What if she didn't realize she didn't have them on until she was already up there?
She knew. Because she told me she had already thought about it.
He was coomish.
She thought about saying no.
She said that.
Yeah.
She said, I wasn't going to do it, but then I said, fuck it. I want to put my, as you would say, her pussy on his neck.
Carter said, no, I got you, bro.
Yeah. Sounds like Carter.
No.
Carter loves saying bro.
So
and I'm Carter, bitch.
It's going to be disturbing to a fiance.
What? Carter's done that to me. He's like, I got you, bro. I was like, all right.
Can you get on his shoulders?
Yeah.
Still, it's, you know, I don't know Carter.
Okay.
So
he's jacked and stacked.
Even if I didn't know him, I'm still not gonna be all right with my fiance getting on his shoulders with
he's a southern
short
gentleman
skirt with no panties on. So I'm still not gonna be all right with my fiance getting on his shoulders with no panties on and a short skirt.
Right. I understand. Why would you really focused on her ensemble, and not so much about the shoulders. So you're saying if she was wearing pants, it would be okay?
That would be a lot better.
What if she was wearing pants and no panties?
Well, at least she's wearing pants. At least her pussy's not right up against his neck.
Right, who said that her bare pussy was on his neck,
though?
That's
such a weird conversation.
Right.
That's pretty much kind of a given.
Is it?
She's on his...
Why is he arguing with Will about if her pussy was on someone's neck?
Shoulders, yeah.
There's no extra like material to the skirt. It's just like straight to vag.
That's what she was telling me.
That she said those words.
She said she was wearing a short skirt and no panties.
Right. So that, yeah, definitely. I can, you know, when you say that, I think to myself, there's not a lot of material to the skirt. It rides real high.
I don't know if she was just saying that to get me going or what. I just get tired of.
Okay, bye. What'd you say? Sorry, not you,
Lauren. I just get tired of having to think about shit like that, and it's, you know, it's just draining.
Right. I understand. I'm just saying, like, you're just assuming how the skirt looks. That's all I'm saying. Maybe there was material between her and her vagina and his shoulders.
You never know.
Maybe.
We're going to have to do a whole Unsolved Mysteries and that's episode why on how the pussy was not on the neck of Carter.
And that's why she didn't think it was a big deal.
No, still.
Still. We should probably talk about it
sometime. Yeah, I get
it.
You don't want anyone touching her. I know that one.
Being mad about it, okay? Yeah, that's definitely not anything. But what do you want to do about it now?
It happened like probably weeks ago at this point, maybe even months.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing that can be done. It's over.
She's like, I'm not going to do it again. So, like, can we just... like, okay.
I mean, just... I don't know.
Then why was Carter's neck soaked? Did Jamie leave brushy juice on his neck? I don't know. Maybe.
That's right, Noel.
Carter has been known to be stacked and jacked, and Lauren was reminded of it many times over.
Yeah.
How could he lift a 6-foot woman on his shoulders if he wasn't? I mean, come on.
Could Jamie even sit on Lauren's shoulders? She'd probably still be touching the ground.
Probably.
Was she titless?
I don't care if somebody touches her.
Come on, Lauren. Let's be honest with ourselves.
It's just things you don't do. It's just things you don't do.
Like hug her.
I don't care if you hug her.
You got mad at us when I used to hug her. I stopped doing that because you got so mad. I think you said to her, something around the lines of, what's with all the touching? What's with all the touching?
Oh, yeah.
Touch.
I remember getting mad about that.
Yeah.
But you have grown to trust.
Oh, you know? Okay. All right.
You've have grown to trust.
Shit was weird back then.
Right. Lauren, I don't want to make you mad, and I just want you to know that she might be cuddling with MJ right now. She tends to do that when she's upset.
It doesn't surprise me. It doesn't bother me.
She's cuddling with the woman.
Doesn't
I know she's not cheating.
That doesn't bother him.
How does that not bother him? That bug the shit
because
out of
me. Because even lesbians want dick at the end of the day, according to Lauren.
They will always come back to cock. Lauren's just sitting there with his hook. Just come get your dinner. That is exactly what he thinks.
Oh, sure. Donation from Nizoki. Did talking to Lauren ever have an effect on your mental health, and have you ever told a family member or partner about your Lauren escapades? Thanks. Do you want to go first?
You can.
Okay. effect on my mental health? I mean, just being frustrated at him, but I mean, you know, just when you talk to him all the time, it gets annoying when your phone is blowing the fuck up. But I think I was fine. I made it through okay. Telling my family, I told my family once, I was wasted on Thanksgiving, and I started playing Lauren calls and telling everyone about it, and my mom was just like, well, as long as he doesn't kill himself, I guess I'm okay with you doing this.
Oh my god.
Yeah, Xavier, I had to light candles. I got headaches from Lauren all the time.
Yeah, I'd say the same thing. I used to have to take naps.
You get stressed out, but yeah. I mean, I'm not like fucked up or anything.
I mean, I'd say for the robot's health, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, if it affected you that much, I don't think I would, you know, I wouldn't do it if I thought I was going to lose my mind. But.
I definitely think it affected it a bit, but I mean, more like a shorter fuse with things. Just because you have to, you have to deal with this just absolute idiot all day long, you know?
I would just say it's more exhausting than you think it is.
Yeah, that's a great way to put it, yeah. But I knew I'd be, you know, just even listening to this shit again, I get irritated and want to just, like, snap at somebody because I'm so mad about
how by the end of the stream, my brain is just hard-boiled.
It's just so stupid. Lauren disorder, exactly. And Will's not here to comment on the on his experience.
Doesn't
I know she's
you.
Not cheating on me. No.
I don't understand.
I know she's not cheating on me. Well, because Maggie Jo's a girl, so that's why it doesn't bother me.
Yep, can't cheat with women.
Can't.
Well,
isn't she in love with him? With her bro?
A question. Did you guys give him an actual phone number, or was it online? Great question. Thank you for that. It was a Google number, but it's connected to your phone, so it would constantly go off. I think I told the story on one of the streams where I was at work, and I had my phone on my desk, and it was just going off. It just kept vibrating. And my boss calls me, and she's like, are you okay? Is, like, something wrong with your family? I'm like... Because my phone was just going crazy.
No, this guy thinks I'm hanging out with Sex Boy.
if there's any other questions, I missed them. Oh, here we go. Swifty. Genuine question. Did acting as a woman in a relationship with Lauren change your perspective on women at all? I don't know how to answer that. No. Go ahead.
I don't know. Robot had programming. Just was running a program.
I mean, what do you mean? I've always respected women.
I think
I was raised by my mom.
I feel like I was raised by my mom as well, and
still
hate them. I respect women. I'm learning from women how to treat. I didn't have a dad. Anyways.
Yep. Bloops is sexist. Confirmed. Put that in my Google Doc.
Put it in the doc.
And then Noel and I can read it together and laugh about it.
Yeah, I think that when it comes to Lauren, he's such a rare breed that I don't think you can, like, compare it to real life scenarios other people may go through, you know?
Just must be so weird as straight guys to be treated as a woman by an asshole dude and what they can put up with.
So,
I thought you were gonna answer that. What?
I just think it's more of Lauren is a special type of person where I don't think most people would even put up with an hour of his bullshit, let alone multiple days.
Yeah.
I don't know if she is or not.
Right.
So, when she went down there, when you guys went there, she told me that she was just friends with...
Oh, sorry. I think someone donated about that, too.
Oh, let me... Ramona's Diaper. What was the story with his hand surgery? You might be more knowledgeable.
He was waking up. It was, like, super late at night, and he was just bitching about how he couldn't sleep because his hand hurt so bad, and his hand was going numb, and then James is like, well, just go to the hospital, you idiot. And he's like, oh, no, I'm going to wait until the morning. So he goes, and I think it was just carpal tunnel surgery. I mean, I could be wrong, because I don't know if that's even a thing, but...
It was.
They went up in his wrist for whatever was hurting his wrist, and it fixed it for a little while, I think, but... that's what it was about. I don't know. I can't remember the actual diagnosis and stuff anymore. It's been a while, but... It's nothing, like, amazing. And then he would always do that stupid fucking Lauren shit where he's like, do you want to see the place they went into my wrist? And Jamie's like, okay. And he sends a photo and his wrist scar is, like, right down by his cock. So you have to see his cock and his scar at the same time. It's like, bro, get a grip. One time he was like... Oh, I think I hurt my leg. I can barely walk. I'm really struggling. It hurts so bad. Do you want to see? And he's just like, all right, fine. And then he's like, he's got his pants off. He's naked.
I remember this one.
And he's like pointing to a point in his groin, and then his dick is just on full display.
It's like 90% dick.
Do you see my boo-boo? Like some shit like that. Fucking idiot. Yeah, Ramona's Diaper, definitely.
I think it was carpal tunnel.
I'm pretty sure it was. One of the two. One of the. I don't know what the second one was, but. Oh, no, it's definitely. It's just like when he would subtly take photos of, like, knickknacks he had found for the yard sale, and he'd stick the head of his dick in the photo and be like, I can't see that.
His dick's in all of them.
Damn near all of them. And some of them's like weird shit, like baby clothes. It's like, what are you doing?
That one was really weird. He took a picture of baby clothes that he was saving for
Jamie
when they have a baby.
Yeah.
And for some fucking reason, he decided to just put his dick all over the baby clothes and take the picture.
Well, not all over it, but
well,
it was in
I mean,
frame.
People know I tend to exaggerate, okay?
Well, not some.
They weren't all over the clothes. I mean, they were in the. It was in the picture.
What the fuck? It was in the photo.
Yeah, he had baby clothes. Where'd he get them from?
Yard sale. I think it's his aunt's yard sale even, too.
What? Why did she have them?
I know he was near yard sale, and he was like, oh, baby, tell me, get, pick out things you want. And one item out of like the however many, he kept saying, like, pick more. The last item that she picked was a bottle drying rack. And he realized what it was and was like, thinking she had baby fever, so he started buying baby clothes and all this other shit.
What does probation think when they go to his trailer to raid it and there's baby clothes and a big black dildo in the same drawer?
And a drawing of three people on the sex.
And posters of the model on every square inch of the wall. Sometimes the same picture.
What?
He had like a poster of Jamie with a picture in a frame on his nightstand, and it was the same exact picture.
Yeah. So that picture, he had two posters of it. The second poster is because the first time they printed it, they did it the wrong way, and he didn't get to see her hair in the poster. So he said, you need to reprint this, and they said he could keep the second one for free. So he got a free poster. He got a photo of that poster, or that picture, on his nightstand. He has one of them. He had made another copy, put it in his car, in his truck, so when he drove, he could see her.
Mm-hmm.
And then he put one in the garden window.
Yeah.
And it's all the same photo. It's not like, oh, these are, this is five different photos. This is one photo. That's it.
Joy Orbison. Was the pic sent of Paula by Blue Boy to Lauren real? Yeah, that was her. I didn't know it was her, because I took them off of Joey TCap channel had a video like a long time ago where he had him in the video. I don't know what the video was, like what it's titled, but you can, I mean, I'm sure it's still on his channel. And I sent them to Lorne, and he confirmed that that was Paula.
Sassy P. Water, this is not the time she was pregnant by John Michael Jr. This was when Lorne thought he would be the dad's child. He just thought she had baby fever, not she was pregnant. Didn't he injure his leg too? And he was on antibiotics a lot.
He was on antibiotics for that.
A little bit.
He had that weird like cyst on his leg.
Yeah, that was before the robot though, right? The one that got lanced, he was talking to Winnie, I think, when that happened.
Then I'm not sure. I don't know.
That like started rotting off of his foot.
Yeah, was that with Winnie?
Yeah, it was Winnie.
Then I'm not sure. What
Casey won or whatever the fuck. He didn't actually injure his leg. He just kind of pulled his groin or something. You know, like he just kind of got hurt and wanted to make sure that he had a way to show his dick. So he, you know, did that. Very stupid.
With Maggie Jo.
Nah, she would never have said that.
Yeah, that's what she told me.
Oh, okay.
And then all of a sudden, I find out that she's confused.
Well, Lauren, to be fair, they are just friends. They're confused. Not dating, right?
Yeah.
So, but she wasn't lying.
When you told me that, she was confused,
uh-huh.
I'm like, well, what the fuck?
Yeah, but you they're know, just friends.
Fucking bullshit.
But they're just friends, Lauren. Like, Shins, I don't remember him with crutches, but there's stuff slipping through the cracks at this point, so I'll let you know if I find anything. And Maggie Jo's engaged.
Yeah, I know. She didn't tell me that she had feelings for her still.
Okay, but she said they were friends, and they are. I don't understand.
Because when they started doing the shows, I told her, I said, if you start getting feelings for Maggie Jo again, then you probably ought to stop doing shows with her.
Okay.
So, it's just fucked up, you know?
Why does feelings have to stop if she, like, why do they have to stop working together because of that?
Well, because if she gets feelings for her, why would you want to keep working with Maggie Jo and take a chance of ruining what me and her have?
Right. Here's my question, Lauren. I don't understand how you're okay with her cuddling with her just because she's female, but you will yell and scream at her for a week straight over a guy she's talking to. Just talking to.
Well. Insecurity.
Right, so you're okay with MJ, but not some random dude she just met.
I am okay with Maggie Jo. I'm alright with her cuddling with her. I know she's close to her, and I know it makes her feel better and comforts her and shit, but...
Her name is Maggie Jo.
That's what I said.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying it to myself.
Oh. But... Her and I have just had a rough day.
Well, there's always another day, you know. There's always tomorrow.
Yeah, I know.
As the old saying goes,
Yesterday was good. Yesterday was good. Just today didn't seem to be quite as good as what I thought it was going to be.
What, you thought today was going to be a good day?
Yeah.
What were you planning?
Yeah, I did. Well... Nothing. We weren't planning anything. I just thought we were going to have a really good time together today.
Oh, well then why didn't you have a good time together?
We just wound up arguing.
Well, maybe you just needed to not argue about something.
Yeah, I know. I wanted to come up with an idea for her to make money.
Oh, cool.
Then we wouldn't have argued, but I came up with an idea, and she shot right off doing it. I was like, trying to tell her, you know, wait to talk to me tonight before you do anything, because that way we can think of the best way she can make the most money. But,
so you got mad at her because you gave her an idea and she went and did it?
I wasn't mad.
Sprinkle Cake, I think the yesterday thing was just to see what he would say as a quote. As the old saying goes, yesterday, and just see if he got anything for that. He just goes, yesterday was good.
I wasn't mad because she went and did it right away. It's just I was mad because she wasn't charging enough. I think she's
what
worth
do you mean by charging enough?
Charging. Because she's worth more than what she was charging.
What makes you think that?
Because I love her.
Right, but that's not how economics work.
No, I know, but she's also a celebrity too, so...
Well...
You know?
Yes, but, and no, Lauren, like, you know...
But I ask her questions, she don't answer a lot of questions, so...
What?
So I ask her questions, she doesn't answer a lot of questions, so...
Like what?
You know, like if she showed her face on the cam and her tits, or just her tits. If she shows her face, then they're gonna see that she's a celebrity.
She's a celebrity.
Mm-hmm. Do you guys think Lawrence capable of committing premeditated murder? Press one in the chat, please.
Doing he's capable. 87. What is 87?
God, a lot of ones in here. Man, y'all are stupid. Just kidding. But
oh,
you are.
No. What was the question? Sorry, I missed it.
Lauren, capable of premeditated murder.
Premeditated? No. No. He doesn't premeditate eating. Let alone a murder.
Yeah, Brian, that's my stance on it. Of course he can hit someone with a truck or, you know...
Yeah.
Do something like that. But
I mean, he got 15 feet of air and crashed into somebody's fucking house. He's definitely capable of some type of murder.
Yeah, this motherfucker can easily kill somebody.
Yeah. But no, not premeditated. Good question.
But what if they don't know who she is?
Pre-yoga murder.
If they don't know who she is, then that's different.
Right, so you're saying she needs to know. You need to know if she was showing her face, so that they can say that's a celebrity. But they don't. Go ahead.
If she's showing her face, then they're gonna know that. Then they're gonna know that she's a celebrity. If she's not showing her face, then it's not gonna make a difference because they're not gonna be able to know who it is.
Right. So let's say she has her face on camera, and someone goes, "I don't know who you are."
Then she can tell them, "Go look at it. Go watch a movie." Here's one of my movies.
I don't understand what the problem is here, Lauren. I'm sorry.
I just think she's worth more.
Right. I understand that you do, but that doesn't mean the general public does. Like, you understand what her industry is, right? You understand that, like, you can get that stuff for free everywhere, right? It's a cutthroat business.
But you still have to pay for it and to watch the movies, though.
No, you don't.
You can see the movies for free?
Yeah.
Man, this guy... When's the...
How's she make money off that?
Fuck, the internet is just...
I can't imagine if you asked Lauren to like, think out deep in his mind how the internet works. Like, how far out can he go into the internet in his mind?
Even in 2007, you can get free internet porn, couldn't you?
Yes. I don't know. He's just... He's a moron. You can get them for free, though.
How's she make money off that? Because somebody's going to make money in order to pay
people
her.
People steal it and show it to other people.
You wouldn't steal a car. You remember those commercials?
No.
It's called premium. But you have to get people invested in you to pay for that kind of stuff.
2007.
Porn, it's available.
For free.
Use it, I don't know what that means.
Oh, Octopushy has been paying Null this whole time. I've been getting it for free.
You wouldn't download a house. Actually, I would. I'd download a car. I'd download a house.
But you have to get people invested in you to pay for that kind of stuff. Again, it's a cutthroat business.
No, I don't know much about it because she didn't tell me much about it.
You never asked about
it. Right, well,
it.
Do you ask a lot of questions? Because, Lauren, no offense, but, like, every time her job comes up, you get weird.
Tell her I support her in her job.
I mean, like, do you remember when her and I used to talk about her job and you get super uncomfortable and say it was bullshit that we were talking about it and that she needed to talk to you about it? And then she did it, like, 2 days and you got pissed off and said, I don't want to hear about it.
Yeah, I remember that.
Okay, so then why are you sitting here being mad saying she doesn't tell me about it? You know why. Because you're given a chance and you didn't like it.
Used to.
You're breaking up.
It takes some getting used to.
Yeah, right, but we're like,
It's not something I'm used to.
Again, but
that thing that was lanced on his leg was from 2019.
Oh. Thank you for verifying that.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Look at that.
Oh my god! I've never seen that picture.
Yeah, picture?
Some dope socks he has on, though.
Yeah, there's some dope socks. I got it lanced.
You didn't like it, so why? If she assumes you don't like it, then why would she continue to be like, hey, I know this pissed you off last time, but let me just say it some more.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Yeah, and again, like, yeah, she's a porn star, but that doesn't make her, like, an instant celebrity, Lauren.
It's on my phone, otherwise I would show it right now.
She doesn't walk, the red carpets of Oscars.
I want to be able to talk to her about her job. It's hard.
Well, I mean, she barely works right now.
Oh, I know.
And the few opportunities she's had, you turned it down from what she told me.
Yeah, well, it's because she's sick. I didn't want her getting more sick.
Right, but I mean, again, there was tests in place to prevent all that. I believe she told you about that.
And you take the test, and you go out, and you come back.
They were quarantined.
You get the results.
She told you that part. They went in, they got tested, and they all went in quarantine for 2 weeks.
Never heard her going in quarantine. She'd be going back the other way you're at and Maggie Joe's at, and company comes over.
He's talking about a hypothetical situation that is so
and sometime in between this, she takes a chance.
It's not even worth, like, stressing out about.
Right, but if you told Lauren, hey, what if this happened, you go, I won't know, never happened, never did it.
Like, imagine if your brain worked like that, you'd be miserable all the time.
Yeah, he's already, like, done the tree graph of it.
Yeah.
He already knows exactly what the ending is. So he's like, well, what about this situation right here? Like, the one where he goes, what if you were doing your nails and my mother came home
right.
for
it's
dinner
like, there's just
and came
some things
with me?
You don't need to worry about.
It's such a... All of the pieces have to be in place.
Yeah.
And Will tried to explain that to him, and then, unfortunately, Will misspoke and said his stupid mother and that. Was the end of that conversation. Ho ho ho, motherfucker!
Call you all about the stupid
okay.
bitch.
Sometime in, yeah. sometime in between this, she takes a chance at catching it.
Company didn't
and those
come
people,
over.
No, but you and Maggie Joe.
Okay, so let's run with
been,
that.
Wouldn't have been staying inside forever.
Right, okay, so let's run with that. So someone comes over and she gets it at the house. So you were worried about her not working because of that reason, but anyone could show up at the house and
okay.
give it to her?
Well, no, what I'm saying is you and Maggie Joe could go out to a store.
Yeah.
No, and you two could get it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, though.
One of you can...
So you're worried...
Somebody could get it and bring it back.
Right. So you're worried about her going
that's what I'm saying.
To a shoot that was already... People were being tested... You were worried about her doing that because she could have got sick. But then you're saying that I could go out today, come home and get her sick.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
The people that she was to work with, they would have been the same thing.
You're just proving
my
point, though.
Chances than... It's taking more chances than what are necessary to get sick.
But you're saying that she could get sick.
She's still trying to recover.
Safer going to a shoot where people are tested than it is for Will to go to the grocery store and come back.
I think it's more just the fact that if Will were to go to the grocery store and get her sick, then why does she have to worry about everything else?
Right.
You know, why do you have to go through?
I mean, he can't just admit it's because she's fucking dudes.
Right. That's it.
He wouldn't give a fuck if she was sick.
Fucking dudes. I was trying to get this. Oh my god.
What is that?
It's this getting lanced. Trying to save it so I can put it on screen. Alright, fuck it, let's take it to him. So that's a call.
Cover.
You're saying she could get sick today. Definitely just by being in the house we're in.
Her isolated time.
Yeah.
Okay, so then why couldn't she work at that shoot?
Okay, then those guys don't know where they've been. If they're actually quarantining,
okay,
or who they're being around,
right.
They get it brought back to them, then she goes and does a shoot with them, she gets it from them.
Okay.
Then she brings it back to you and Maggie Joe.
Right, okay, so I can go to the store and get it and give it to her today. COVID.
Yeah.
Okay, so she could. So if that's the case, then why couldn't she go to the shoot?
What I'm saying is, why take more chances than necessary?
Right, but if there's a chance of me giving it to her every day,
plastic on every
day, then there is no, like, the chance is there every day. Right?
Right, the chance is there every day from two people.
He's putting himself into a shoot here.
So why take the chance of getting it from any more people?
Well, why not let her just work? Why not just let her be an adult and make decisions?
Mm-hmm. Because it's like she's still trying to recover from the being sick before.
That I don't see how that's an answer to my question, but okay.
Do it if she wants to.
Well, you said no a bunch of times.
I said that I didn't want her to. I didn't tell her that not to. I told her that I didn't want her to.
Lauren, she told me the whole conversation. You said no.
Well, yeah, I said no. I don't want you to.
Right, and then she said she's gonna do it, and you said some harsh words, and more or less said like, "If you do that, then yada yada." Like, there's some sort of consequence.
Lauren is indeed regarded.
I probably did then.
Right. So, I mean, again, like, it's almost no offense to you, Lauren, but it's like you forget what you say, and you just think that like, you only said one version of something. And that these things shouldn't add up in her mind because you say sorry later on. You know?
No.
You wouldn't let her work with MJ and her fiance for work because they would have made a lot of money there.
It's too personal. It's too close.
Why?
Because it's too close.
Who? Why do you get to deem what's close and what isn't?
Whatever, you know, it doesn't fucking matter. So I'm not in a relationship with just her. I'm in a relationship with her and you and Maggie Jo.
No,
you know,
it's just like you're not very understanding. It's
fucking bullshit.
Yeah, her friends are in the picture. That's pretty normal, I think.
Well, hold on, you're telling me that you're going to have friends when we're together? That shit's not going to fly with me. Trust me, your brains will get scrambled. Lauren does not know that they have heavy testing in the porn industry. He's an idiot. It's just like a tornado, where she'd be safer at home than 5 miles away for some reason. Yeah, Elephant J, it's just stupid logic. Just utter stupidity from the adult.
Oh, yeah, when Jamie had to go home because the tornado can drop down at any moment.
It could drop down at any moment. It could be her house. It could be down the street. It could
but, like,
not even
who
drop
would know
there.
Better? The person who's in Tennessee where the tornado is, or Lauren?
Probably Lauren, because he knows what tornadoes sound like. Okay. He's just, I don't know. It's all about knowing where she is at all times, but not making it obvious that it's because of dudes. So it's like tornadoes, football game with 25,000 people, and the virus, and I don't know. Did you know that Lauren one time said that he wishes a tornado would pick him up and drop him off at her doorstep?
I didn't know tornadoes just drop you off gracefully.
Yeah, it's like when you play the flute in Mario 3 and you go flying. It's just like that. And then I think the robot asks, like, wouldn't you be naked? And he goes, would you want me to be naked? Ugh, God. Fucking dummy. Little cartoon character, Lauren, floating through the sky in a tornado.
I gotta get off the phone, Will.
Oh, all right. I'm just trying to have an open conversation with you, bud. That's all.
Yeah, I know. It's frustrating as hell when I'm trying to have a relationship with one person and all of a sudden I got three people involved.
Right. Well, I mean, most relationships, you share friends and family and they're involved in your relationship.
Yeah, they're not that involved, though.
Right. Well, I mean, she tries to express things to you and you don't listen.
No, I listen, but she's constantly telling me that I'm not listening.
But, I mean, I'm explaining things to you and you're saying, yeah, I might have forgot that, or I might have done that back then. But it's like, you know, I had to talk you there.
It's stuff that takes some getting used to for me because I'm not used to the business at all.
Right, but Lauren,
or being that, you know, that close to friends where, you know, I trust my friends more than the person that I'm with.
Right, but Lauren, if you're not comfortable with those things, you shouldn't be with a person like that. You know, it's like if I went out and married a bungee jumper and I said, hey, I don't want you bungee jumping anymore. And she's like, well, why? And I go, well, because I don't like it and you're engaged to me, so stop fucking doing it.
And it was like, she doesn't share shit with me.
What do you mean?
She shares it with you and Maggie Jo.
Shares?
She doesn't share shit with me. Anything.
Like what?
She doesn't talk to me.
About what?
She never has. She talks to you. She talks to Maggie Jo about anything. What? About anything.
Like what?
Name something, you fuck.
It's fucking bullshit.
Can you just name an example?
Thank you, Will.
Anything. It doesn't matter what it is. You name it. She doesn't talk to me about it.
Okay.
So I asked her a question. She doesn't answer it.
Lauren, she calls you up, right? And she goes, hello. And then she just sits there in silence for however long you guys talk.
Pretty much. I gotta be the one to start the conversation.
Is that a mini syllable while he's lifting something?
Pretty much. I gotta be the one to start the conversation. I gotta be the one to think up the conversation.
Right, well,
I tell her about my life constantly.
Right? You're the one that gets mad when she doesn't call you at the designated time, correct?
I tell her about my life constantly.
Okay.
Things I'm doing and what's going on with it and everything.
Can we just go back to my point real quick?
The only thing she tells me is she's sick and she's not doing anything today.
She doesn't. She's
doing the same thing every day.
Because every time she tries something new, you get mad at her.
I don't want her getting sick.
Right,
how can I be wrong in not wanting her to get sick?
Talking in chat rooms is going to get her sick?
That was my insecurity because of the fucking bullshit I've been through.
But it's like you forget these things happen. And you're just saying, oh, I don't want her to do because I don't want her getting sick. That had nothing to do with her getting sick.
No, I know the chat rooms don't.
Right. You would get mad at her for playing cornhole. You got mad at her for, you know, going in the hot tub all the time at one point. Those have nothing to do with her getting sick.
No, those are me.
Yeah, I know they are, Lauren, but it keeps adding up. And then she's like, well, I can't do that because he's going to get mad again. Can't do that because he's going to get mad again. What's she have left? She can sit in her room and be quiet and read a book.
Depending on the book.
Well, I don't want her doing that. I want her to be able to...
Right.
You don't
do you see the point?
I just don't want her getting sick.
Do you see the point?
Well, she can't sit in there and play Donkey Kong. We know that.
I kind of wish that Jamie had started reading books and, like, fell in love with a character in a story and just never shut up about him. Just to see if Lauren would get mad at a book.
He would. He got mad at Donkey Kong.
Yeah, you care more about that goddamn book than you do about me.
Egbert, yeah, I talked about at the beginning, just his new RSO, he just looks terrible. He looks so miserable. What was the robot okay? Doom 1993 and not external. Jamie needs to get her head out of her ace. Here's on Sweet, the original Doom is a masterpiece, so Jamie plays it all the time. I think we're gonna stop here soon. There's still 40 minutes of this call, if you can believe it.
Alright.
Let's get to a good stopping point.
I do see the point.
Okay, I'm just making sure, because, like, you're extremely hard on her. Again, she was just talking to people on the internet, and you just lost your fucking mind.
I know. Well, that's my insecurity because of the crap that has happened to me on the internet.
Right, but she's not you.
I know. She's...
So why should she have to pay for your sins?
She amazes me all the time.
Right, but why should she have to pay for your sins?
No, she shouldn't, but...
Right, but you make her...
It's the things that... Like, Emma. I know you don't want to, but that's part of it.
But here's the thing. She's not talking to anyone.
That's where my insecurity comes from. That's where my insecurity comes from, is that bitch.
Okay, that's fantastic, Lauren, and I'm sorry you feel that way, but what does that have to do with her?
It doesn't. It's just my insecurity.
So you screaming at her over someone she's talking to on the internet because you have an issue, how is that fair to her?
That's not fair to her.
Right, so wouldn't she be upset about that? And just because you said sorry, you think that fixes it?
No, I don't think it fixes it.
She says that's how...
This sounds like a dad having to talk to his child about how stupid he is. About feelings. And do you know that other people have feelings?
She says that's how you act.
That's a start. Well, it's a start. At least I realize that.
Right, so you don't backpedal at all. And say stuff like, if you had told me that he was such and such.
No, I do backpedal a little bit.
Okay, so then it's not a start. Because you just go back to where you started, right?
Well, I know. But she backpedals, too. That,
well, on what?
That kind of makes me backpedal something, too.
What does she backpedal on?
On dump truck.
What?
On dump truck. Because I lied to her once about dump truck. She thinks I'm going to lie to her all dawn.
How is that her backpedaling?
She's going back to the past.
That's not what
you just brought up Emma. Are.
Sorry, I was breathing in the stupidity. They're talking about backpedaling, and he thinks it's about talking about the past.
I'm getting sleepy.
Lauren thinks that backpedaling is the past. And not, you know. Alright, guys. On that note of pure dullard, we're gonna call it for the night. This was something else. I hope you guys enjoyed. If not, hopefully the rest of this call is to your liking. If not, we have Christmas Tree Origins on the way. Is it exciting? It's all right.
It's funny.
It's Christmas Tree. Don't say him.
I'm not gonna say him.
But it's Christmas Tree, the same color, he says the two dumbest things back to back.
Yeah.
Is it?
It's that one.
Okay. Banger quotes in that call. History making, in my opinion.
There's two things Lauren says in this call that might take the cake for dumbest things he's ever said.
It's very stupid. And I can't wait for you guys to hear it. It's shocking almost. When we get to it, I'm not even going to say, oh, it's coming up.
No, you'll know. You'll know when you hear it.
When you hear it, it's so fucking stupid. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it from us. You got anything else? Love donated.
Yeah.
And he said, been called fat or old. What do you think it bothers him the must?
The most.
The most? Well, it says must.
It says must, but I mean, you can.
What bothers him the most, being called fat or old?
I think he probably dislikes being called fat more because he doesn't think he's fat either.
The most.
Like, which one do you think he's more offended by?
Yeah, which one would set him off more? I think he gets more defensive about being called old than fat. He's always like, I'm not old, that's not old. Fuck, my mom's not old, she's 80. You know, shit like that. Whereas when he's called fat, he just goes, no, I weren't. I'm working on a six pack right now.
Well, and he knows he can, like, lose fat, but he can't
he loses
reverse
it all
his
in
age.
The summer.
Yeah.
In the summer, he sweats off all the fat in his body. He starts over. It's like he sheds
his skin. I mean, I don't know
if
he gets offended by either of those things, really.
I wouldn't say annoyed, or offended, but definitely annoyed with the being called old and fat. But, you know, repetitively.
He's so delusional, though.
That is true. I mean, he thinks he can... So... I don't know. Anyways, that's going to be it for us this week, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you all to who donated. I hope you had fun. We'll be here next week to listen to the rest of this call. Let's see if Will can talk some sense into him. Probably not. And then we'll be on Christmas Tree. Okay? Paper thin walls. Goodbye.
Bye.
Taste the biscuit, taste the goodness of the biscuit. Taste the honey sauce, taste the goodness of the biscuit with the honey sauce. Don't get that honey sauce on me. I don't like the way it tastes with my chicken wings. Taste the biscuit, taste the goodness of the biscuit. Taste the butter spread, taste the goodness of the biscuit with the butter spread. To get your butter spread all on me, I don't like the way it mixes with my mac and cheese. 'Cause when you're at KFC, you got that special sauce to stir my curiosity. Just give me a 5-piece meal, oh what a deal. A big old box, it's all for me. You know I'll take coleslaw on the side. I could tell you wanted to try the potato wedges. Goodness of the biscuit. Taste the honey sauce. Taste the goodness of the biscuit with the honey sauce. Get your honey sauce on me. I don't like the way it mixes with my chicken wings. Get none of that honey sauce on me. I don't like the way it tastes on my chicken wings. Take us out, Moose.
Taste the biscuit.